think there was a lot of materialism in the last 10 years where people, because they had it, they had to spend it. And because they were spending it, they had to make sure that other people knew that they were spending it and knew that they had it. And that, you know, I think somewhat may have coarsened cultural life and social life a little bit in Ireland. And I think also people probably didn't realise fully the sources of their wealth. They thought that it was all their own work, that it was just that they were so good at whatever it was they were doing, that the salary that they were getting and the opportunities they were getting were all generated by themselves, which of course wasn't the case. The reality of the Celtic Tiger is that the foundations for the economic growth that took off in 1994 were laid, in the case of the low tax policy, in 1956 by the late Gerard Sweetman, Minister for Finance. In the case of free education, which produced the young people who were attractive to foreign investors, a decision taken by the late Donough O'Malley in 1966. Then in the 1970s, the establishment of the regional technological colleges by Pádraig Faulkner, another man who's none of these three people are much talked of today. And yet their decisions were the decisions that created the Celtic Tiger that happened to just really burst out when I was fortunate enough to be the Prime Minister. But I would be the first to say that the foundations of that success were not laid principally by myself, but by people who, many of whom had left politics before I even entered it. I do think it was possible. I think you can divide the Celtic Tiger period up into two. There was the period from, you know, 1994 to 2000, when the very rapid growth, up to 11% per annum in 1997, took place. And that was entirely founded on productivity increases that were taking place at that time and export markets that Ireland was winning and competitiveness gains that Ireland had made. Around 2000, those factors started easing off, and really the growth should have eased off at that stage and we wouldn't have so many problems today. But from 2000 on, there was this rush of credit into the Irish economy from the international banking system, thanks to securitization and other things. There were Irish banks pressing money on people, pressing money on individuals to borrow money to buy a house in the Algarve or something like that, pressing money on building developers to, you know, we'll offer you 100% of the cost to buy a hotel in New York or to build houses in Bulgaria or whatever. And there was this wall of money that was just being pushed at people. And it was the use of that that generated artificially rapid and unsustainably rapid economic growth from 2000 up to 2007, which wasn't founded on real improvements in productivity, but was founded on speculative activity, which was based on the assumption that prices only go up, they never go down. Now we know house prices don't always go up, they can go down, and there are a number of individuals with unsustainable financial positions and a number of Irish banks with unsustainable financial positions from which they have had to be rescued by the Irish taxpayer. But I think you need to make the distinction between the earlier first 7 years, if you like, and the second 7 years.